So, what's it like to actually work on a film set in LA and the breakdown of it all? Intro. One of the things that was the most surprising coming into the LA film industry was that everybody works as a freelancer, which simply means you are hired by the project for your skills. That's tough though, considering you need to be consistent to pay for the things life throws at you. But we are not talking about that today. But if you are looking for some advice, I did a video on networking in my last video, and I'll put a link right here, and I'll also put a link in the description down below. So, what does the hierarchy look like on a real professional film set with everyone's different positions and roles? This is typically consistent through music videos, films, and commercials. So, give or take, I might have some mistakes here and there. Let's start at the very top. The client or the person wanting a commercial comes to a real video production company and says, "Let's make a baby." That production company then says, "Okay, what do you have in mind? What type of baby?" After getting treatments, pitches, and ideation with different possible directors out of the way and done, the client then approves the go-ahead. Typically, to get things moving, we bring a producer into the picture. A producer's job, in short, is to oversee the production from development of scripts, managing the finances, coordinating the crew, to ensuring final delivery of the project. But it really just depends and can change given different scenarios. The director who is brought on board is in charge of the artistic and dramatic aspects in regards to trying to make this script a reality, whether he or she wrote it. They are also in charge of directing the actors. While there are a lot of things that happen before we start shooting, let's just imagine a perfect world where the client, production company, producer, and director, we're all on the same page, but we all know that's not true. Production day. What are the different departments? First off, we have the production department, which consists of the director, creative director, producer, and the first AD and second AD. A creative director is somebody who leads and assists in the creation of visual concepts alongside the director. Typically, they come from the production company. Now, this was the thing that was the most interesting to me when I started working on these film sets. The director is not the one who is telling all the crew what to do. That is the job of the first assistant director, or the first AD. The AD helps the director to focus solely on the creative by running things in the background, passing along everything that needs to happen down to the different department heads so the director can sit chill and fancy. The second AD is in charge of getting actors or talent through HMU and wardrobe, or hair and makeup, and getting people dressed and ready to go. HMU and wardrobe fall in the vanities department. Moving on to production support, which consists of your production assistants, who are in charge of helping in any aspect, typically the first to arrive and last to leave, sadly. They set up everything from video village and client village, which I will explain in a bit, tables and chairs for meals and crafty, and assisting the ADs and producers in any regard, and I mean anything. And it sucks. We then have the camera department, who consists of the director of photography, which we call a DP, or your classic cinematographer. Then we have our first assistant camera and our second assistant camera, but we call them ACs, first AC and second AC. The director of photography is in charge of the aesthetic look of the film, commercial or music video. How are things going to be lit? What camera lens are they gonna use? They're the camera operator most of the time, but the DP does this with the guidance of the director, of course. The first AC is your focus puller. He, she makes sure the subject being looked at through the lens is always sharp. They sit there in this little chair and monitor, and they just are comfortable all day. The second AC is in charge of the slate, or the little clapper thing that you'll typically see on some film sets. They mark the scenes, shots, and they're also in charge of marking all the paperwork for the camera department. The first and second AC are also in charge of setting up and taking down the camera equipment on set. Next, we have the electric department, which consists of your gaffer, best boy electric, and your electric guys, or girls. The gaffer is the head electrician, responsible for the execution of all lighting on set. He, she works directly with the cinematographer. The best boy on set is just the assistant to the gaffer and is in charge of all the electric guys and girls who set up the lights and manage power. Because let's be honest, we use a lot of juice on set, pumping it through all those lights. Then we have the grip department, consisting of the key grip, best boy, and grips. The key grip is head of the grip department and also works directly with the gaffer and DP to shape and cut the light that the electric department put up. Like the best boy in the last department, they assist the key grip and are in charge of the other grips who are setting up the rigs and supports to shape and cut that light. Yeah, there's still more. The art department consists of the production designer, art director, and set dressers. The production designer is the head of the art department and takes the writer's work, the director's vision, and the producer's plan to help make the set or environments come alive. The art director assists the production designer to maximize their budget and the schedule of work that needs to be done, and managing the other set dressers, who are there to help build props, set up props, and the final aesthetic of the set. Everybody has a specific job on set, so if you're a production assistant thinking you're gonna go be helpful and move client village monitor, don't do that. They'll get pissed at you. I've done that. They don't like it. Ask the second AC before you do it. Oh, before I forget, client and video village are just where we have monitors set up for the clients, the producers, and the directors, so everybody can see what's happening through the lens of the camera. This was a long one, but if you have any other questions about the video production process on a professional scale, ask away in the comments. And if you have any questions in general, don't feel nervous to ask. Until next time, like, subscribe, and share. This is a community, so ask away.